Welcome to CoreCon today for March 8th, 2019. This is where we give you a look at some of the biggest stories happening in the past 24 hours in the world of cord cutting. Now, if you're new here, hit that subscribe button, hit that thumbs up. Hopefully, we can help you break free from the high cost of cable TV and still watch the content you want with weekly cord cutting Q&As, how-to guides, news briefs like this one, and more. Now, if you want to learn more about these stories in the show notes down below, I'll pull a link to each one so you can read about them for yourself, come up with your own opinions, and let me know what you think of each topic and what you think I got wrong. I would love to hear from you. First, a quick deal. If you're a Sprint customer, they're now offering a 30-day free trial of Showtime, typically only 7 days. But right now, through the Sprint Rewards app, you can get a 30-day free trial. You be a Sprint customer, need the specific app to get it. Link in the show notes to learn more about that. If you're not a Sprint customer, you can get this deal from Roku through the Roku channel, where they're offering a 30-day free trial of Showtime, Epix, and Stars. You can get all three or you can get just one. Link in the show notes to details about that too. All right, getting into the news, lots of big news happening, including some new rumors about the Disney Plus streaming service. This is a new service coming from Disney later this year, meant to take on Netflix, and it will offer new original movies and shows, including new Star Wars programming, High School Musical, and more content that will be original. Plus, according to reports from Polygon, that it will include the entire back catalog of Disney movies on it. Now, this is a little different than what was first reported. It was first reported that like Netflix, they will rotate what content's on there. So you may have a collection of Disney movies here. In a few months, they'll rotate out, but some others, and every month, just kind of new content will keep coming. Now, it's possible both of these are true, but according to Polygon, at a Disney investor meeting, one of their sources say that Bob Iger, the CEO of Disney, reportedly claimed that the entire back catalog being made available through the streaming service. I would not be surprised to find out both of these are true, that yes, the entire back catalog will be there, just not all at the same time. Maybe they still will rotate it, but they intend to put the whole catalog on there at some point. I don't know. We'll have to wait and see. Of course, Disney has not confirmed this, but I would click that link down there to read through the full details of what we know about Disney Plus, the streaming service, and to read Bob Iger's reported comments according to Polygon. I'd love to know, what do you think? Do you think Disney's really going to go all in and have everything available for under 10 bucks a month? Or do you think that Disney will have everything, but in a rotating fashion, similar to Netflix, Hulu, Amazon, etc.? Let me know. We also learned more about the Tableau automatic commercial skipping. Tableau is a DVR for over-the-air antennas, very popular with cord cutters. It was initially announced that this month they'll be rolling out a feature that will allow you to automatically skip commercials and recordings. Well, now Tableau has said, hey, we're still working on it, but we want to get it perfect before it launches, so we're going to delay that until April just so we can work out a few more bugs. But it is coming, and it is in the process. They still say that the quad-core 4-tuner version of the Tableau DVR, not quad-core, the quad Tableau DVR will still be coming out later this month. So link in the show notes if you want to check out the Tableau DVR skipping. It will be available on all older models that subscribe to the Tableau DVR service. It's a pretty cool feature. Link down in the show notes to learn more about that. Let me know. Would you buy a DVR with commercial skipping? Would that be a factor in you picking which DVR you get? I'd love to know from you. All right, Locaast is a free streaming service that takes basically your local over-the-air channels and streams them to you for free, as long as you're willing to be pestered about donating a little bit for it. Now they've announced that they're starting a competition. We kind of reported this earlier, but now they're making it official, where they're going to pick the next market where they're launching Locaast based on your donations. So Locaast is saying they need about $250,000 to launch the next market. That covers getting the rights, you know, some type of rental agreement or something to put an antenna somewhere, the equipment that's needed for this, the bandwidth, the servers, the physical antennas, and more to launch in the next city. Your donations will help pick that. I'll put a link down below if you want Locaast to bring free over-the-air TV streaming to you through apps and Roku and Fire TVs and more. Link in the show, it's down below if you want to donate to join that. So basically every dollar you donate gives you one vote towards your city. I think Seattle, last I checked when I recorded this, was the one in the lead at this moment, but it was well within range of many other cities at that time. So check out down below if you want donate to try to get your city to be the one that's picked. And last story up, we just posted the top 10 free Roku channels according to Roku as of March 2019. Now, Roku has this great thing where they keep track of which are the most popular free channels, paid channels, and other categories. We just broke down the top 10 Roku free channels of May 2019 according to Roku. Link in the show notes down below if you want to check that out. Let me know, what would you add to that list? What do you think shouldn't be on that list? I'd love to hear from you on that. All right, hey, if you're new here, hit that subscribe button, hit that thumbs up, helps us greatly. We'll see you on Monday. Of course, we will have the weekly cord cutting recap show tomorrow, but these daily updates happen Monday through Friday. So I'll see you on Monday for the daily, see you Saturday for the weekly. I hope you all have a fantastic weekend. Hopefully the weather is a little nicer wherever you are as we slowly crawl our way towards spring. But again, hey, thanks for your support. Thanks for those thumbs up. Thanks for that subscribe. Unbelievable. I really appreciate your support. We'll see you again here next week.